Hey guys, TGCast Productions. So this video, I am doing a buying customization and review of one of the new vehicles that was released, the Los Santos Summer Special DLC in GTA Online, and that is the Lampadati Tigon or Tigon. This vehicle can be found in the on the website Legendary Motorsport. Retails for $2,310,000. One of the more expensive vehicles with this update, with the exception of the two new open wheel ones. It's one of the first vehicles advertised by Rockstar a few weeks back with this update, and this is definitely one of the ones that I wanted to buy and start driving around first. But in any case, here says, "Look at the Lampadati Tigon, count to three and try not to adjust your pants. Ready? One, two. Yep, we called it. This car's sole purpose is to please the eye, thrill the heart, and leave you sticky with delight." So that's the caption for this car. We're going to go ahead and purchase it. We're going to do a little test drive before customizing it, checking out the customization after that, and then we'll get on with the review of this vehicle. So we're going to take a look at the Lampadati Tigon before customizing it, as well as taking it for a quick drive. But this vehicle is based off of the De Tomaso P72, and if you want a little more information or background on the real-life version of this vehicle, I'm going to be doing that towards the end of this video. So this is pretty much just the look of the car before customizing it. We're also going to go to the remote functions here and see everything that can be opened up on the car as well. And you're going to see here pretty much the doors as well as the engine is able to be opened up. We have the sort of complete vertical opening doors that was added, or Rockstar started adding vehicles with these type of door openings with the Ill-Gotten Gains update back in 2015. Definitely pretty cool. A lot of vehicles, I would say at this point, GTA Online have this, or at least a good handful of them, this type of opening. But you can see the engine is pretty opened up there, very detailed. And we're also going to take a look at the interior of the car as well. And what's pretty nice is we got some cool Lampadati emblems, actually one by the backs or in between the seats here. We also have one on the steering wheel. And I'd say pretty much the rest of the car, been interiors that we have seen in other vehicles, but pretty detailed interior. Definitely like it. I always like to see like the car emblems inside the car as well. So that is definitely really cool. But we're gonna take it for a quick spin here. What I like to do is I always like to drive it. If you've seen my other buying customization review videos, what I like to do is I always like to drive the vehicle before customizing it, just to get a little bit of an idea of the handling of the vehicle, the little bit of maybe acceleration, barely scratching the surface of top speed, and then sort of maybe like power steering, which sort of goes into handling. I like to just kind of get a feel of those aspects. And for the most part, what I can tell you, because obviously I haven't in-depthly tested this at this point, everything felt pretty much average, for the most part, as far as like, handling, acceleration, power steering. I wasn't really underwhelmed or impressed with any of it. It just seemed pretty much what you'd feel with a lot of the other supercars in GTA Online. I know, for example, like when I tried the Ocelot Jugular, a car that was one of the drift feed vehicles for Diamond Casino Resort update, I could tell as soon as I drove that car that I was like, wow, the acceleration of this car is crazy. And it actually ended up having one of the most fastest accelerations of the sports car class. I didn't really get that with this car. For the most part, everything, like I said, just seemed average. Like I said, I wasn't overly impressed, underwhelmed at all. Like I said, pretty much what you would expect to feel as far as like, power steering, handling, acceleration, speed, all of that. But what I'm doing here is we're going to take it to my CEO office garage, and we are going to check out the customization of the car. That's pretty much what we're going to do next. And then after that, we'll do a little bit more of a review on what the car handles like after the customization. So here's the customization of the Lampadati Tigon. Like my other buying customization review videos, I'm not going to be showing you me actually customizing the car. I'm going to show you my final product after going through the customization. I just want to show you what all the options are for this car. If you were maybe considering buying it, you wanted to sort of see what it all has to offer. And for the most part, pretty much all the customization has to offer, I would say, is pretty generic. Most of what you would expect, obviously all the typical stuff like armor, suspension, engine, brake upgrades, all that. Some cool, spoiler options, skirt options. Nothing super special. I'd say the most unique part of this car, what you're actually seeing here, is the back exhaust. The back exhaust is pretty unique on this car. fact, the only other car that I remember that has an exhaust that is similar to that is the Benefactor Krieger has an exhaust sort of up by the engine of the car, sort of like where that or the exhaust is on the Lapidotti Taijuan. So that is definitely very, very cool. Probably one of the most, or I would say more unique aspects of the car, but everything else for the most part is pretty generic. We have our unique liveries. We saw Rockstar, I remember with the Diamond Casino Resort update, they, at least back from when I remember when I started doing these videos, they were doing the at least around 10 unique liveries for each of those cars. I know at least specifically for the drip feed cars. And you can see here pretty much have 10 unique liveries as well that I'm going to go through. The only other thing I can mention is, and one other thing even before that that I wanted to mention when I first started driving the car, it is cool that you can actually see when you're in. I sort of saw this when I was in first person, but obviously the upper part of the doors or the windows on the doors sort of go up above on the roof, which is really cool. So it's a very open car, almost makes you feel like you're in a convertible in a way. I did want to say that really quickly as well. But the only other thing that was really cool as far as like maybe customization is concerned or like cosmetics of the car is the wheels. The wheels are unique to the car. So, you know, you're not going to be able to find these wheels or be able to purchase them for any other cars. And they are pretty much the wheels that are actually on the De Tomaso P7-2. They're very similar, if not pretty much just about exactly the same as far as appearance is concerned. But that's really just about it. Like I said, I think the coolest parts of this car are the exhaust, pretty unique. And then also, like I said, we got the custom wheels, which are a number of the, you know, a lot of vehicles, GTL that have their own, custom wheels that are unique to that car only. But that's pretty much about it. Everything else is pretty generic, and I'll pretty much let you guys just check out the rest of the customization if you would like to. What I'll be doing after this, like I've done with all my other videos and bike customization review videos, I'm going to pretty much show you my final product of the car, I guess showcase that. And then I am going to also just drive it around real quickly one more time just to get a little bit of a feel for the car, you know, what it's like after adding all the modifications as far as like engine turbo that is actually going to, I guess you could say, boost the stats on the vehicle.
Making decisions is stressful. How many cars you got in this garage again? Think long and hard. You can think it, I can do it.
Whatever you desire. Technology and budget permitting. Almost indestructible. Bodywork to match the driver.
So at this point, I'm going to give you one more final look at my final product of this car, give you 360 view here. And as far as like the paint job or the respray is concerned, I end up going with a primary grace red color, a pearlescent red, and then a secondary black, just a regular black. And if you saw in the, when I was customizing the vehicle, you saw that the primary color pretty much covers the majority of the body of the car, and then the secondary color covers pretty much the framework around the windows and the exhaust as well. So that's pretty much where those colors cover. I kept the car pretty generic for the most part. I didn't add a lot of customization on this, like spoiler or skirts, anything like that, because the real life version looks a lot like this. I wanted to keep it like that. So kept it pretty generic. I also kept the stock wheels on as well. As I stated, these are special to the car. This is the only car that has those stock wheels. So I wanted to keep those on as well. Mostly a lot of times when the stock wheels are special to the car, I will keep them on. But at this point, I'm just taking it for a quick drive. Just want to get a feel for what it feels like after it has been, you know, fully modded. And pretty much the only thing that's going to like boost the stats here is obviously like the engine upgrades, the turbo upgrade, or, you know, brakes, all of that. You know, those type of upgrades, those are going to boost the car. And for the most part, as I said earlier, the car feels pretty average as far as like handling is concerned, you know, power steering, speed, all of that seems pretty average. You saw maybe a little bit earlier, a little bit on the speedometer of how fast I was going. You can't necessarily gauge top speed on this kind of road because obviously there's turns. You know, this highway goes sort of uphill and downhill, so you can't really gain, you know, a really accurate top speed on that. But like I said, I'm very comfortable with the car. You know, it feels pretty average. You even see up here, I'm weaving in and out of traffic. I was very comfortable with the handling. So I would say at this point, the biggest question sort of becomes, you know, as far as like top speed is concerned, and I may do a video to in-depthly test this top speed as far as like where it ranks in the supercar class. Depending on where it ranks may determine whether or not this is a car worth getting as far as like competitiveness is concerned. Because the handling seems fine. The only thing I didn't really like that much is I tried to like drift around it a little bit. Supercars aren't really meant for drifting, so this car isn't really the best for drifting. You don't really want to drift in races anyway. It's going to slow you down for the most part. But if it ranks really high with top speed, if I end up doing a review with that, definitely probably is going to, you know, put this car in the higher rankings. And I would say, yeah, you're probably going to want to buy this car if, as far as, you know, if it ranks high with top speed. Because if the handling is good, it has good top speed, probably going to be a pretty good car for races and competitiveness. So overall, like as far as giving a review of the car, You know, I do like the car. I definitely like it, you know, Lampadati. We don't have a lot of Lampadati cars in the game. It's sort of a brand they're adding more and more of into the game. So I am liking that. We don't have a lot of those type of cars. So that sort of, I guess, is a plus one towards this car. You know, as far as uniqueness is concerned, I mean, I wouldn't say the look of the car is super unique. I'm sure there's some other cars detailing we can compare this to that look similar. It does have the sort of that cool, unique exhaust by the engine, which is very cool. Like I said, the Benefactor Krieger has something similar to that. Not a lot of the cars have that. Taillights even sort of look pretty cool. They sort of go into the car a little bit. But other than that, pretty generic car. Like I said, we'll have to see maybe with top speed where it would rank to see whether this car a good car for competitiveness is concerned. But I am comfortable with the handling, like I said, with what all comes with that, like power steering, all of that I'm very comfortable with. And one last thing I want to leave you guys with, I said I was going to talk a little bit more about the background of this car. This car is based off the De Tomaso P72, which even though this has a Lampadati brand on it, which is actually an Italian car manufacturer, this car is actually based off, as I stated, the De Tomaso P72, which is a completely different Italian car manufacturing company or automotive manufacturer. We've seen Rockstar do this with like the Pagassi Zeruso, where it looks much like a Lamborghini, a lot like a Lamborghini. Pagassi is a Lamborghini car brand. However, the Zeruso is actually based off of a different Italian car manufacturing company, Italo Design. So just because it has a Lampadati car brand on this doesn't actually mean it's made by Lampadati. But in any case, the De Tomaso P72 is based off of a mid-60s version of sort of the P70, I guess De Tomaso P70, or like a race version of that car. What's actually cool is there's only 72 of this car being made. So they pretty much took the number in the name, the P72, and made 72 exclusive variations or versions of this car, which is really cool. So there's only 72 versions of this, or 72 of this car, which is really cool. So very exclusive. So I just wanted to give you guys a little bit more background on the car. But in any case, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you found it beneficial. Hope it gave you some good information on this car. But as always, please don't forget to like, subscribe, share this video. Be sure to comment if you have any questions. And have a great day.